the men's evaluate nutrition education interventions. And the course does not have conventional lectures. It's not about having a professor giving information to the students for them to memorize or to learn. It's actually a process in which students develop communication skills needed for nutrition educators. They see nutrition issues in terms of knowledge, attitudes, and practices. And this is done by really going to the field and talking to people in the community. So they are confronted to the reality. They also learn to recognize processes by which people change food practices. They become familiar with nutrition education actions. Analyze nutrition education activities to identify the strengths and weaknesses. Then they learn how to plan and implement nutrition education interventions. They actually have a project, a nutrition education project they have 2 years to plan and implement. They know how to review and practice a range of nutrition education strategies and practice advocacy for nutrition education. So the course was developed for health and nutrition students, but there's a big request also for agriculture students. Now that we're talking more about integrating nutrition into agriculture. But for these students, some basic nutrition knowledge is needed. Then the course was piloted with professionals working in nutrition and health, with NGO staff, and also with teachers and community workers. But for this last target audience, we saw that the course requires adaptation. So the course was developed for different levels, undergraduate students, postgraduate students, so at masters, but also professionals already working. So this is the course. There are two modalities, so the face-to-face course. This is the CD you will see in the ethno stand. It's actually coursework, course materials, and tutorials. So this course is used in the university by university professors and university students. There's also another modality, which is the online course, which was developed in Moodle. It's not a course that students can take it on their own and simply get a certificate in the end. It's actually a tutored course, meaning that a tutor is following the students in their learning. And the course requires 150 hours of work from students, and is divided into 10 and a half units, which are the ones presented here. So it's the need for nutrition education, explaining food and diet, nutrition education actions, how good eating is learned, how nutrition education is done. And from unit 6 on, it's about more the implementation. So it's about analyzing the situation, objective messages, motivation, implementation, monitoring and evaluation, and the last unit is more about the wider picture. So this is where students learn about how to advocate for nutrition education. And each of the units is composed by lessons and activities, so coursework, that can be done individually or in groups. They also contain outside activities, so this is where students go to the field to discuss with communities where they are confronted to their realities. And they have a project work in which, yes, they have to design, implement, and evaluate a nutrition education intervention. And the tutorials are done, yes, twice a week, where students and professors meet to discuss about the learning acquired, to do debates, play roles, etc. Role plays. And well, there's a wide range of materials for tutors and students that you will find in the CD. So these are just some pictures to show you about the interactive tutorials. So the students do not simply sit and listen, but they discuss, they debate, they interact. And these are also the outside activities which explore aspects of the real life. These are some pictures of the nutrition education project. We can see some, I think this is Kenya, where they develop fruit kebabs, and Ghana, and others. So whether the course has been tried out, it has been tried out in 7 Anglophone African countries, 5 Francophone countries in Africa, of online courses has been tested in Wageningen University and South Africa, so UNICEF University. It was then further tested in Honduras and Sri Lanka. So these are some pictures of the pilot. So what are the results so far? Here are some quotes from professors and students and from the an external evaluation of the field. So the approach is of excellent quality, fully relevant to the context targeted and appreciated by both tutors and participants. This was a comment from the evaluator. Then, educating without hands-on experiences is like pumping gas into polythene with holes. Another person said it was hectic but necessary to group better nutrition indicators. With the lecture method, we were used to memorize what the tutor was teaching us, whereas tutorials make us think. So it's about also critical thinking. The ENAC model was very successful at increasing competencies of the students in nutrition education. We believe these students are going to be completely different from their predecessors who didn't do the course. Finally, I now realize that up to now I was lecturing, not giving education. So now we have the course, but what's next? So now ENAC is becoming part of the curricula of universities, of our partner universities that piloted the course. But this is not enough. Because the adoption of the course, we need the adoption of the course by further institutions for scaling up nutrition education training, and for effectively promoting healthier food-related practices and better diets. So actually we are doing now promotional efforts. This is why we are in Annex 7, to promote now the course with other universities who would be interested in integrating ENAC or ENAC, the proper version. And also FAO is developing a strategy to train more professors in the ENAC approach. Also, there's a great demand to adapt ENAC for health and community workers. So I think we can now move to the experiences from pioneering countries. So I will give the floor to Lau Gato. She will present the experience in Burkina Faso.
Débouché budget pour les étudiants après leur diplôme, le profil des enseignants, le profil des étudiants, les ressources, donc par exemple l'accès à des ordinateurs, à une connexion Internet, les disponibilités en temps, la durabilité en termes de continuité du cours, et puis bien sûr essayer d'avoir une bonne distribution.